We are joined now by the chair of the House Homeland Security Committee, Congressman Peter King. Good morning, Congressman.
Good morning, George. Good to be with you.
Well, boy, you sure are stirring up a hornet's nest here. You're being accused of modern-day McCarthyism, fueling bigots. I understand your purpose, but why not beat back the critics by broadening out the hearing to contain all sources of domestic terrorism rather than zeroing in on a single religion?
Because, George, this is where the threat is coming from. And, you know, this isn't just me saying this. Just on Sunday, when Dennis McDonough, the president's deputy national security advisor, when he gave his speech at the mosque in Virginia, he said that Al-Qaeda has changed its tactics. It has now made is making a determined effort to recruit and radicalize within the Muslim American community. He didn't mention any other community. He gave the speech to Muslims saying that is what Al-Qaeda was attempting to do. And it would, to me, it might be politically correct, but it makes no sense at all to be talking about other types of so-called extremism when the major threat to the United States today is coming from Al-Qaeda, and Al-Qaeda is attempting to recruit in this country. And as Eric Holder said, I believe in the last 2 years alone, there have been 50 homegrown terrorists arrested in this country. He said that he can't sleep at night, or he stays awake at night because of the threat of domestic radicalization. Janet Napolitano said the threat level has never been higher. So to me, it might be politically correct, but it would so diffuse and water down the hearing, it would serve no purpose. If you investigate everybody, you investigate nobody.
But as you know, the Attorney General did not single out Muslims in that statement, and there's an awful lot of evidence that the Muslim community is taking on this threat. In fact, the greatest single source, according to Duke University study, of tips turning in potential radicals is the Muslim community itself.
Yeah, that's actually a very misleading report. They include cases in there, for instance, such as the Zazi case in New York, the subway bomber. They give an imam credit for turning him in. Actually, the imam tipped him off, and the case is almost broken. They give credit to the vendor in Times Square who saw a car on fire, and he reported it, and that was the Times Square bomber. How did he know that involved a terrorist attack? That report was skewed. And I go back to what Eric Holder said. You look at the numbers. No matter how you look at it, that is the Muslim American community he's talking about, the overwhelming percentage. For instance, in the last 2 years, there's been no terror indictments of neo-Nazis or skinheads or environmental extremists. So the fact is, and when Dennis McDonough spoke on Sunday, what he was talking about was he said the Muslim American community is being targeted by Al-Qaeda. That's the reality.
But do you have any law enforcement officials testifying at your hearing who will say that the Muslim community has not been cooperating in trying to turn in these radicals when they find them?
Better than that, George, I will have people from the Muslim community who will say how when they went to law enforcement, how imams attempted to stop them, how they were threatened when they did want to report. When the FBI began investigations, how the imams in their mosques told them not to cooperate. These are the people on the ground. The main witness is going to be Muslims, people living in the community, showing how they're intimidated, showing how their families are being radicalized, and showing how the imams and other leaders and groups such as CARE are working against them. So to me, that is much more effective evidence rather than having some law enforcement person talking about statistics. I'm going to have a person on the ground. I can tell you from my experience, every law enforcement person I've spoken to in New York has told me they do not get the cooperation. I give examples
of mosques. Are they going to be testifying?
No, because I get so many witnesses, and I have the people on the ground to have these Muslim Americans who have themselves been victimized by their own community, to me, is much more effective.
And you're not concerned that this is going to backfire, that by focusing on the Muslim community, you'll actually cause that community to turn in on itself?
No, I don't. In a democracy, the idea is to get the facts out there and let the people decide. And again, you're saying focusing on the Muslim American community. Isn't that what the president's deputy national security advisor did on Sunday when he gave a major speech saying Al-Qaeda is attempting to radicalize the Muslim American community?
Congressman Peter King, thanks very much.
Thank you, George.